Lunar eclipses, that is, when a full moon completely enters the Earth's shadow and turns red, were the key to spotting eclipse patterns. When the moon passes into the Earth's shadow to create a lunar eclipse, the event can be seen from the entire nighttime half of the planet. When the moon casts its shadow on the Earth during a solar eclipse, the eclipse can only be seen from within the moon's shadow. So astronomers would see roughly half of the lunar eclipses that happened, as opposed to only a handful of solar eclipses. That gave the astronomers enough data to figure out that lunar eclipses seem to repeat every 18 years, 11 days, and 8 hours, a pattern which we now call the Saros. And it turns out that the Saros also applies to solar eclipses. If a solar eclipse happens here, another one with a similar path will be visible 18 years, 11 days, and 8 hours later. However, because of those extra 8 hours, the Earth will have rotated 120 degrees farther around, and the eclipse path will be shifted 120 degrees westward of the last one.